Nice officer, man. He was pretty cool. I think I passed it, but when I pulled in the truck stop, I took my seatbelt off. I always do. I don't know. I feel like I got more maneuverability. I did get a $25 ticket for that. So I don't know if I failed the inspection for that or passed. I hope I pass because I get $200 if I pass. Find out. I get amnesia. I forget that you keep coming around. Yeah, ain't no way you ever let me down. Good God Almighty, I hope you find me. Praising your name. All right. Let's probably put this on. First load of the week. Welcome to Wabash. If you're gonna come to GP, better get used to this place. I like it. A lot of guys don't, man, but they're normally 24/7. Sometimes you come at the busy hour, you're gonna have a 7-8 hour wait, but it's expected. It's expected. Yeah, if you don't like hauling paper, don't come to this company, man. But with the split sleeper berth, you know, if it is a 7-8 hour wait, I run that. Take a nap, wait till they call me. Screws up my whole starting time. All that. These guys will keep you running, man. These guys will keep you running. Definitely our biggest customer, I believe. Yeah, should be a good week. So they're finishing loading me now. About a half hour. Can't beat that, man. Paperwork's on a Sunday, probably the quickest you'll ever be in and out of here. But yeah, 700 mile run to Fulton, New York. I've been here before. It's a little, it looks abandoned. It's like in the back behind a warehouse. Easy delivery, nice people. So start the week off with a nice 700 mile run. I like that. And then something going on, my dispatcher, he on Thursday, I called in. I thought I was going to talk to him, and they said he has some family emergency or something, so I hope everything's well with him, and should see him Tuesday, so hopefully he's still there. Boris is a cool guy, man. He's a good dispatcher, on point, confident, gets stuff done, man. He runs me, so I look forward to seeing him, and I'll be leaving here in a few minutes, go grab my paperwork, and I'll be out. Good day. So, I failed a level one inspection today for two reasons, and then I also got a ticket. But the DOT guy was really nice, man. He actually taught me some things. We ended up talking for like almost an hour. Took a picture of my Buzz and Woody on the truck, and he put it on his Facebook. Real nice guy, man. So, the reason I failed the inspection. So when I left Wabash, I slid my tandems to where it usually should be. And then I went to go weigh it at a Love's about 20 miles away. And I slid it. And then when you slide your tandems, you know, when you stop sliding them, you press in the trailer brake and then set them again. And then you know, pull your trailer either backwards or forward a little bit. And then your tandems will slide and the pins will pop out in the hole. And I did that. I thought they popped back out, but I didn't go look. And so the pins were in between the holes, so they weren't sticking out and set. So I failed because of that. And then, so I learned also another reason I failed, and something I learned today I didn't know. So when we do Wabash or any of these paper loads, we get these giant rolls of paper, and it's usually like two or three on top. And normally I just run a strap across, and it's in the FMCSA book. If you're hauling paper loads, the big rolls of paper, you have to use a load bar. And I didn't know that. I don't think many drivers do that. I've never seen another driver do it. Maybe they do, I don't know. But it's actually in the FMCSA thing that you have to have a load bar. It has to be a load bar. So I failed because of that. Not the end of the world. Hopefully I don't get fired for that. I don't think I will. I've had a couple incidents since I've worked here, but yeah, it was a learning experience. The DOT guys, the first DOT guy I've had them DOT over the years get me for little things, and they're just looking for crap to nail you with, and give you a ticket for something stupid. Most DOT, I just feel like, are, I don't think they care about your safety, you know, and they're just looking for some, they're looking for a loophole, a technicality that they can hit you with, fine you with. And the only thing I got fined with was a seatbelt ticket, and deservingly so. When I pull in the truck stop, man, like when I know I'm gonna park or even fueling, man, I always take my seatbelt off as I pull in. I don't know. I feel like I can, if I need to lean and reach around and look, I don't know, man. I don't like having my seatbelt on when I'm trying to park and do stuff at the truck stop. But I'm gonna start doing it, man, because I don't want to get nailed again. I didn't even see him, and he was nice enough. They can give you a $25 ticket or a $125 ticket. I don't know the legality behind it and all, but he was a nice guy, man. He gave me the $25 ticket, and he taught me some things. You know, if the rule book says something like, you know, paper rolls, it actually says that, you know, when you haul paper rolls, you got to use a load bar. You know, he actually pointed it and showed it to me, and you know, at least I actually learned something. And the guy was real friendly. We talked for a little bit, and it was nice of him, man. It was real nice of him. And he did a full level one. If you ever had a level one, you know, they check everything, man. So he didn't find anything else wrong, and he taught me some things. So he's a nice guy. He's just doing his job. So I'm not mad at him, man. And I learned something. Now I know when I haul paper rolls, you know, I don't know the article code 309 dat what dot whatever and all that, but it is what it is, man. At least, you know, if I make a mistake, I want to learn from it. So, you know, I take accountability for my mistakes. It is what it is. Your seatbelt ticket, you know, that's just something I do, man. And I'm going to have to change that up, man. I'm going to start. If I pull in the truck stop and I line myself up at the spot, I'm going to take my seatbelt off. I took it off as I was coming into the truck stop. So, I mean, it is what it is, man. Those are the rules. I know that. So, that's on me. Hopefully GP won't be too mad at me, but yeah, that was my day, and I drove about 550 today. I'm about 288 for my delivery, so I'll wake up around 3 in the morning to go do that. You're right here in the background on my TV, on my Xbox, I got my NFL app, and I'm able to watch the games they broadcast and stuff, so I'm waiting for I just watched the Chiefs come back and give it to the Browns. Man, I was hoping the Browns would do it, but I bet on the Tennessee game. They let me down. What happened to Derrick Henry that game? And I'll try to. I'm gonna lose some sleep tomorrow night, but I'm gonna make sure I watch my Ravens play. So, yeah. Have a good one, guys. God bless.